In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use a mixing board with no post-production to get awesome live sound, live feed sound, live stream sound, or just YouTube sound. Good stuff, good stuff. Check it out. I'm about to upgrade my mixer to a digital Zoom L12 mixer, but today I'm going to show you my old setup, which I just recorded a bunch of videos for the electric guitar channel, and I'm using the Yamaha MG82CX into a Nikon 5200. So I wanted to show you this in case you're thinking about live streaming or just recording your own YouTube videos, or just if you just want to see what I'm doing, this is what I'm doing. My studio is a mess. Like, it's a disaster. Look at this. It's like everything's all over the place. I'm gonna get a little technical so you can see how I plugged it in, how I go into my computer, and then I'm gonna show you that you can do this right into Facebook Live and show you how to use the headset buddy to do that. But this is Yamaha MG82CX. The reason I bought this board was because it was like cheap, a couple hundred bucks on eBay. It has compressors. Okay, it has two compressors on these channels. It has enough just for me to go into my guitar and stuff. It also has effects. So I wanted a little bit of compressor and a little bit of an effect to be able to go live or to be able to stream this right into my D5200 Nikon. So I don't have to do a post-production, so I can just sit down, do a little mix, and do all that. How I have this set up is I have a lot of cool stuff. I have my pedal board for my guitar that I really went direct into. I have the Trio. The Trio is amazing. This is like a little looper pedal. It does like drum beats, it does that stuff like that. And then yesterday, I had my iPad right here. All of that going into this mixer, okay? Now for my voice, I was using this microphone. So if I wanted to use the microphone, I could use it. And it just looked kind of dorky on the thing. So what I used was this microphone, which is the Rode. It was an overhead microphone. I just had this right over my head, and this is one of the Rode mics. I plugged that Rode mic in right here. It's a little thing. It's like a little XLR to a single thing, so I can use my Rode, which is usually plugged into a camera, right into a mixer. It actually worked pretty good. Now this mixer though is creating a bunch of noise. It's just hissy. I think it's the when I got this mixer, it had some like gunky stuff on it, and some of the knobs were kind of gunky. It was just used, and I think that overall it just is noisy. I don't think that these mixers are noisy. I just think this mixer is noisy, this exact one. To record this before, I could go right into my Zoom H4, which I picked this up. We use this for our podcast. It's fantastically beautiful. It's beautiful. This thing is amazing. You know, yesterday what I was doing is I was going into my Nikon D5200. So I was taking this little cable right out of my RCA out of this mixer, okay? So this cable is like this, okay? It's a RCA out, record out, and I was going like this right into my camera. Bink! And then the D5200 has an audio meter, so I could see what the audio meter was. So it was working really good. I think this, for levels and stuff, that was actually brilliantly working good. But one thing that I did talk about, one of my videos that went huge, was the headset buddy. So this is the headset buddy right here. I have it hooked up to my camera tripod. If you want to go into your phone, so if my phone was my recording device, if I had my phone up here, you would actually use the headset buddy. And people have been asking me a lot of questions. That YouTube video got a ton of views. I'll put this in the link here, the headset buddy. It just changes it to line level. So it takes anything like your mixer output, and it changes it to where you can actually put it right into your phone. So that's the key. If you wanted to go on a mixer and do a bunch of mixing, but you wanted to plug that mixer into your phone, and this place is a mess. I can't even believe I'm showing you this place. It's just an entire mess. You know, it's just, I'm gonna clean this all up. But today, before I tore this all apart from my shoot, but look at my shoot. So if I'm doing my shoot, then it just looks like, you know, looks really good. So other than that, if you take that down, it's like, oh, there's cables everywhere, there's lights everywhere, there's this. New computer that I'm getting ready to build is shoved up under there. and then all my pedals and all that just looks like a, oh my goodness, it looks like a total mess. Okay, so you can see that just going from all of the stuff I've got, my iPad, my everything going in, my loop pedal, all going into the mixer, then the mixer going out into my Nikon, and then in my headphones, I was wearing headphones during the video shoot, I was listening to myself and I was like tweaking and making it perfect, and then I don't have to do any post-production, so I don't have to do any post-production. That is the one setup. Now, the next setup I'm gonna be working on, I believe it's gonna be epic beyond anything, because it's the Zoom, L12. It's basically all of that in one. It's the mixer, it's the recording device, it records multi-track, it can be interfaced into Logic. So that's coming tomorrow. And when I get all set up, I believe it's gonna be cleaner, clearer, crisper, better. The board itself was like $5.99, so I have a couple mixing boards. I'm just selling them, and it'll pay for that. So, and also the H6N is like $3.99, $300 or $400. That just records. So this new board will do everything all within this. So I'll just get rid of this, all these little pieces, and then I'll be able to use the Zoom L12 to do everything. And even to do live Facebook, to do streaming, to do podcasting, to do everything I'm gonna do, and I'll show you all that. So guys, if you have any questions, I know you might have some questions about the headset buddy, I might have some questions about how I'm running this mixer into live stream, but my goal in this setup, remember, my goal in this setup was not to do post-production mixing, so I'm just trying to do a Facebook live feed, but I wanna have like my drum machine, my guitar, my vocals, I wanna be a musician on the live stream. So I'm running everything through this board, which is phenomenal. I looked up this board actually. This board is only $250, or even the newest version of this board is only $350. $200 to $300. You get onboard effects, you get onboard compression, you can mix everything together, and you can run it right into your camera, or using something like the Headset Buddy, you can run it right into your phone to do live stream audio that's way better. So you can check out some of the videos that I've done with this setup. Maybe I'll link some of those videos. I did some electric guitar videos with this setup, and then I'm gonna boost up the setup and make it even better with the Zoom L12. So make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel if you like this stuff. Let me know what you guys are thinking, what you guys are thinking about in terms of what you wanna do, and I'll show you in the next couple weeks the new setup. God bless you guys.